This list is extremely important. It's the Comic Fams list. It's the list of the collectibles that were released in 2021 that the community are after because they're hot, because the artists and writers did something so amazing. They didn't just serve their readers, their fandom. They served the collector's market.
That's right. We've been looking at everything. It's a year in review. We've been looking at the variants. We've been looking at all the independents that have been released in 2021. But today we're specifically taking 10 comic books that have sold for over double cover price throughout 2021 that were published in 2021.
Slap the like, hit that subscribe button. We do have two giveaways we're doing in this video. And at the list at number 10, we have Mad Cave Studios, Nottingham, issue number one, seeing $40 average sales. Hot damn.
Yeah, Tom, this might be Mad Cave's biggest hit so far. You know, they had the Knights of the Golden Sun, which pretty much was one of their first books that they published. What's interesting about Nottingham, well, first of all, it's something that most of us can relate to, the Robin Hood story, except it is gory. You know, it's vicious, it's brutal. But the creative team behind it, David Hazen and Shane Volk, they won the 2019 Mad Cave Talent Search. So this is pretty much their first foray into professional publishing, and they have a big hit on their hands.
They made a bunch of different printings of this issue because it started gaining steam, making the issue one cover A difficult to acquire, which is why it's selling for a pretty penny right now. Next at the list, at number 9, we have Taskmaster number 3, seeing $20 average sales, a gorgeous Valerio Giangiordano cover, and a key book because of a character appearance on the inside.
This is the first appearance of Taiguki, and I'm sure that, you know, in the comments, if we mispronounce it, we'll definitely be corrected. Taiguki is named after the South Korean flag. This is a Korean superhero, and Marvel has really gotten behind the Korean superheroes this year. You got Luna Snow, you have White Fox, you have Crescent. You know, there's a lot. It makes you actually wonder who's pulling the strings behind Marvel, right?
Maybe they're assembling a team. Well, this also is the first partial team appearance of the Tiger Division.
That's right. And another character, Luna Snow, is on it, who actually just released her third K-pop single. So, I don't know, Tom, if there's a copyright behind that, but we might have to play a little clip of that.
Zoro, see what we can do. And at the list at number 8, a comic book that blew up partially because of the secret incentive variant. We have the Joker issue number 2, James Tynion the 4th, coming in strong multiple times on this very list. We have $15 average sales for the first appearance of Vengeance, the Daughter of Bane.
Yeah, I mean, James Tynion, he is just cranking out characters left and right. A lot of them female Bat characters. You got Miracle Molly, you had Punchline last year, now you have Vengeance, which is the worst case scenario of a situation that could happen. You know, when you're dating a girl and you eventually go, you meet her family, and then she ends up looking exactly like her dad. I'm not exactly sure if this is a character that will endure, but so far, so good.
So true, Nick. And DC's been having a killer year. We have 5 DC comics on this very list, Comic Fam. And I think a big part of it is character design and new characters in general. With James Tynion not on the run anymore, I don't think DC's going to want to let off the gas anytime soon.
DC is doing what's working for them. They have really everything is kind of Batman that's coming out, which, you know, could be criticized, but Batman works for DC. And another thing that works for DC, seems like they have a lot of opportunity with Wonder Woman because there's a ton of Wonder Woman content that has come out and is coming out, and including in 2021, number 7 on the list, which is Future State Wonder Woman, the first full appearance of the Brazilian Wonder Woman, Yara Flor.
$15 average sales for this book. When this came out, it made the trending list a few times, and it got international recognition. I was following, you know, DC Brazil more than ever because of how much buzz this character was causing.
Yeah, there's like a Brazilian fans of this character alone.
That's right, and it's why this book was being specced upon and was being heavily solicited with a slow rise. Big shout out to another book that made the top comics of 2021 list over on Key Collector Comics. Didn't make our list here today, but worth mentioning as an honorable mention. Dark Knight's Death Metal number 7, the first cameo appearance of Yara Flor, seeing $8 average sales. Next, at the list, at number 6, we have an idea that's not so bad, but kind of bad because we're talking about computers taking over the world. ENIAC number 1.
ENIAC number 1, $35 average sale. It's interesting, especially in that it's the flagship title of Bad Idea. So keep in mind, when Bad Idea launched, they established a production company called All Nighter. And is that a coincidence? I don't know. But you would think that they would be moving into some production with some of the stuff that they're putting out there, like ENIAC. And I think that this has legs for the future. Although right now, I know Bad Idea. Look, it's easy to criticize Bad Idea for their marketing tactics.
It's a bad idea, Rock. You even hear the bottle of Zop.
And I think the difficulty of people not being able to get their books and read their books is somewhat of the problem. I mean, they're putting out a quality product, right, Tom?
Absolutely. You know, I've gone on the record to say multiple times that I've been constantly impressed by the paper choice, the gloss, the style, the prestige formats. Everything that they're doing is really with the collectors in mind. So although I do hear the frustrations of the community not being able to get them as easily as other titles, the collectors are being served more by this company than any publisher in 2021.
Yeah, and you got to find a way to cut through the noise. I mean, you got a company like AWA Upshot, which puts out a lot of great stuff.
You quality.
Know, it's run by Alex Alonso and Bill Gemmis, two former Marvel executives. But they don't get the type of attention for what they're doing like Bad Idea, because Bad Idea is putting this sort of controversial marketing behind their books, which is a huge effort in its own right.
Rumors have it that Bad Idea is ending, even though I don't think they're going to be gone for long.
Who knows? But what we do know is that as far as this list goes, we have independents dominating it along with DC, not as much Marvel. But number 5 on the list is Noctera number 1.
Noctera 1 seeing $18 average sale. Scott Snyder behind this independent comic book through Image has already been optioned and is headed to Netflix the same year of release.
I'm always a little wary about these announcements when right around when the book is released or shortly thereafter that, oh, hey, it's been optioned for Netflix. But there has been some continued media coverage that now they have a writer on board. So this one might happen, but you never know with these.
What do you think, Comic Fam? Let me know in the comment section below. Two winners will be announced next week. We have Something is Killing the Children, the Raph Grissetti exclusive of issue number 16 that could be yours if you let us know what you think about this list in the comment section below. At the list at number 4, Batman Urban Legends issue number 6, seeing $30 average sales and mainstream attention.
Yeah, DC really seems to be making the news. I mean, they've had a few headlining things that occurred in 2021. Getting them the attention in comics that Marvel gets in TV and movies. So, DC just might be going a totally different route towards success with comics.
This is the issue where it's revealed that Tim Drake is indeed bisexual, and this blew up the internet.
DC's been making a lot of headlines with the directions that they're taking in comic books. They've definitely grasped on to the social commentary and stories and story arcs. And whether that's something that is resonating with readers, it's definitely getting them attention, which is quite possibly why we're seeing so many of the books that they have on this list.
And what's this at the list at number 3? The Nice House on the Lake, issue number 1. One of my favorite reads of all of 2021, and one of the most surprising, mind-blowing reads as well. And a lot of the community members agree with this. A lot of high hopes for this comic book. $15 average sales, and I think it's going places. What about you, Nick?
I think the title of this book is it sounds kind of like a criticism of being too frivolous with one's money, right? Oh, nice house on the lake.
That's right. And a beautifully drawn house, by the way. Quite expensive to put that thing together. I do enjoy that most of this narrative takes place in one location, making an option potential something a bit more believable than some other comics that have been optioned on this very list.
Yeah, nice house on the lake, Tom. It actually returns in March after taking a hiatus after the sixth issue, which actually is, you know, I don't know if this is a new thing that's happening with these creator series, like Noctera as well. I think the last one was in August, number six, and they've taken a hiatus until, I don't know, March as well. But this could be possibly something that we might see in 2022 with paper shortages that we're hearing some of these publishers are running into. I don't know if these are going to affect these independently created books and titles that are getting a lot of attention.
Yeah, we've definitely experienced the paper plastic shortage of 2021 going into 2022. A lot of publishers having difficulty even making graphic novels. Image has even gone on record to say that they're not doing second printings. What's happening, comic fam? Hit the like, slap the subscribe. And at the list at number two, a book that made so many trending 10 videos, ranking so high, we have Star Wars High Republic issue number one seeing $15 average sales.
I don't think that there's any franchise in comic books that has benefited more than Star Wars based on these Disney Plus series. I mean, of course, we've seen a lot of value increases and back issues because of Disney Plus on Marvel. But really, the Star Wars phenomenon, as far as comic book fans are concerned, it seems to be at a fevered pitch.
I got to hear from you, Nick, what you think, because this is the earliest era of Marvel Star Wars canon that exists now. And I'm curious where you think this comic is going. Will it sustain? Are we going to see any type of increases in your opinion?
It all depends, but you know, it's pretty surprising that a book with such a high print run has sustained the value that it has throughout the year. It's all going to boil down to February when this sort of High Republic era of storytelling reaches its conclusion and what that climax is going to look like and what's going to come out of it and where they're headed afterwards.
And now we're at the list at number one, the number one hottest comic book of 2021. A big round of applause. Shout out Tony Fleece and Trish Forstner. We have Stray Dogs issue number one.
No surprise to anybody. I mean, this book now is selling for $65 for issue number one, which is huge for, again, another independent book. And they are now continuing. They came out with a one-shot. They have another limited series coming out. The one-shot already got reviewed well. So who knows how long this can last for.
Now, I remember back when this book came out, Key Collector was preview to this book already having received the badge of option status. What can you tell me about that, Nick?
Again, it's one of those things that I feel I'm always really hesitant about the optioned news that comes out prior to the book going on sale or when the book is on sale or the run is still continuing. It's like when a Kickstarter option happens and the Kickstarter is still live. It's like, I'm not sure if I should believe that. But this Stray Dogs, we haven't heard much of anything else in terms of television, but these things take a long time. So it's entirely possible that something could be in development, but nothing newsworthy quite yet. All I know is this, Tom, they're going to have to start making more horror movies in Hollywood so that Stray Dogs has variant covers to homage, right?
Absolutely right. We have Lady and the Tramp meets Silence of the Lambs. And what's curious, I wanted to point this out. We have issue two and issue three as honorable mentions, both receiving $10 average sales still. And I suspect that's because this run started gaining attention right around issue four. That's when members really started going heavy and buying multiple copies. And that's when the variant covers really started to become as popular as they became. So many horror homages that was a brilliant decision to be done and largely piloted by Tony Fleece and Trish Forstner. So many of these covers, they did themselves and they were the ones making sure that the approval process was to their liking.
It's a great success story for creators to make a name for themselves who didn't do so with established legacy characters that have existed for decades.
We appreciate your time today, Comic Fam. While we have Nick on the line, what can you tell us about what is in store for the community in 2022 as it pertains to the best comic book app in existence?
Tom, before the end of January, we're going to have an update that is going to give the Key Collector community more search options to allow them to find what they're looking for quicker. We have a ton of features that are coming out. I have so much planned. All I can say is I appreciate 2021. Billy wanted to pop in real quick and say thank you, everybody, for supporting Key Collector. And we're always here to listen to your feedback. We want to know what's going on with you, how you're enjoying the app. And thank you again.
Happy New Year, Comic Fam. As always,
geek responsibility.
Nick, it's responsibility.
I'm sure it is.
Enough said.